They have calculated in the casualty, okay? But if it is not calculated, from now on, every case sheet should have the height and the weight, and the weight has to be calculated according to the height. So these are all must from now on. I will not tolerate not having mentioned all this, okay? Now, second, so because we are concentrating on enteral nutrition, okay? So as soon as possible, make every attempt to, if the patient is conscious, okay, he'll take orally. If he's not conscious, a Ryle's tube should go in. So we cross-check the Ryle's tube by an X-ray, or if the clinician is bedside, you can ask him to cross-check the Ryle's tube, whether it's in position or not. Okay? After that is there, what do? You start initiating feed. So when you start initiating feed, till now you have been, what we have been depending, you know, when the patient is very sick, we have been writing the prescription on the case sheet or on the doctor's notes ourselves, but most of the time we have been leaving it to them. That is going to change. From now on, if the doctor has not written the exact prescription, run behind him, ask him to write down the prescription. Okay? So, because only when he writes the prescription, you follow the prescriptions, right? So, we'll have a class of doctors how they write the prescriptions, but from your point of view, measure the height, weight, Ryle's tube in, prescription has to be in, has to be written. Another next change. From till now, every feed that was going on was 1 ml is equal to 1 kilocalorie. Okay? Now, we have been facing much problems with that. That is going to change from now on. Reason is, you see, every patient who is sick in ICU, you find them bloating up, right? They gain weight, isn't it? And when the patient gains weight in ICU, and that is not a sign of nourishment, that means you are not treating it properly. You are giving unnecessary extra volumes. That has to be cut down. So from now on, 1 ml is equal to either 1.5 kilocalories or 1 ml is 2 kilocalories. So we will write down the prescriptions and accordingly. So the volume goes down from now on, the calories goes up. And the doctors will have to write and they will calculate the feeds, how much calories to go in, how much proteins to go in. You have to start preparing it accordingly and give it, delivering it accordingly. Okay, then he spoke something about assessment. Anand is here. Okay, fine, then leave it. So he spoke something called global assessment, subjective global assessment. You see, subjective global assessment, it is very subjective. What is subjective? It's like happiness. I mean, I can't decide who is more happy, you or you. Both of you look unhappy though, but I can't decide who is more happy. So it's very subjective. So, and in that SGA, they decide who is well nourished, who is moderately malnourished or severely. That is not going to change the prescription of the ICU. It is going to decide the outcome of the patient, but that is not going to change the prescription of the patient. Okay? Do you understand? Even though you write down A, B or C, the prescription remains the same. What you can assess from an SGA is, what is the likely outcome of the patient? Is the chance of survival high or low? But prescription remains the same. Now the thumb rules of every patient is that if the patient is sick, though he has told you 25 to 30, we try and follow much simpler so that things are much clearer and it's much more protocolized. So if the patient is really, really sick on multiple inotropes, multiple organ failure, 15 kilocalories per kg body weight, simple. If the patient is recovering phase, 25 kilocalories per kg body weight. Patient recovered, 35 kilocalories per kg body weight. Theek hai na? So, 15, 25, 35 kilocalories per kg body weight. Okay? If the patient, the protein requirements, 1.2 grams per kg body weight. Okay? Patient on CRRT or HD, hemodialysis, it is 2 kilocalories per kg body weight. Okay? So, accordingly, everything has to be done. So, for example, now since you have, I'll take you through a case scenario and I expect some answers here. So, for example, a patient, a 50-year-old man who's a diabetic, very badly controlled sugars, has come with pneumonia to the ICU. His because he's not maintaining his saturations, he's also hypotensive, he's on a lot of inotropes, and he's ventilated now. So, and when he came, you measured his height, and it turns out to be, say, around 160 centimeters. So put the formula in place. The formula is in place. Okay. So you calculate the weight of the patient, 50 plus 2.3 into 65 minus 60. So this is 5. This 2.3. How much is this here? 15. 12.5. 11.5. Okay. So it is 61.5. So this is the weight of the patient. He is now very sick. So this is expected from you. The weight has to be written in the case sheet from now on. He is very sick. How many kilocalories you want to give him? So into 15, right? So into 15. So 6. Kitna aa raha hai? How much is it? Someone calculate and tell me. Boss. Okay. So for example, it is 900. Okay. So this patient needs 900 kilocalories. Okay. Fine. So this is understood till now. Okay. Now let's go next. So till now, if the patient needed 900 kilocalories, you were giving 900 ml. That is going to change now, isn't it? So because 1 ml is equal to 1 kilocalorie, so till now we were giving 900 ml, right? Huh? This is going to change now. So from now on, we will prepare at least 1 ml is equal to 1.5 kilocalories. So somewhere between 600 ml should be sufficient, right? 600 ml should be sufficient to make 900 kilocalories. Okay, isko laga. So 600 ml. So can someone tell me, when you use, for example, ProSure, how do you make it? Suppose, so ProSure contains 1 ml is equal to 1.5 kilocalories. Okay, the what else you have? Nephro HP, right?
Yes,
that contains 1 ml is equal to, isko pakad kar, 1 ml is equal to 2 kilocalories. Okay, so for example, now, so the doctor comes and writes now RT feed and 50 ml per hour. So in how many hours are you going to reach 600 ml? In 12 hours. In 12 hours, you can reach 600 ml, right? Yeah, 12 by 60. So, in 12 hours, you are going to reach 600 ml. My point is, how do you prepare this 50 ml? And how much calories does each 50 ml contain? Yeah, if it is Nephro HP, it contains 100 kilocalories. Okay? So somewhere you have done wrong. So 100 kilocalories Nephro HP contains, and if it is ProSure, it contains 75 kilocalories, right? So in 1 hour you are giving, either if you are giving Nephro HP, you are giving 100 kilocalories. If you are giving ProSure, 75 kilocalories. So if you are giving 100 kilocalories of Nephro HP, so in 12 hours you are giving 1200 kilocalories, and here you are giving 900 kilocalories. So with a lesser volume, you are giving more kilocalories, and that is how we are going to change the thing now. Okay. Now next, supposingly this patient, we have to take him for a CT scan, and you spend around, so for a CT scan, and then we have to put lines for dialysis and other things. So we have lost, say, around 6 hours of time. How do you manage the gap then? Yeah,
overnight.
One is overnight. That is the easiest part to do. But if you understand the concept, you yourself can manage it now. Yeah. Because so either you can increase the volume, because you know now that if you understand the whole concept, you know somehow I have to reach 900 kilocalories, or I have to reach 1200 kilocalories. If you understand the concept, even if the patient is going out, so either you can increase the volume a little bit, because we are giving 100 ml till now, you can make it 75 ml, but that all we'll do later on. Right now, for starters, we don't discontinue feed at night and we reach the target. Okay? For the starting part, I mean initially we'll go with no stopping of feed at night and continue it overnight. People who absolutely understand the concept, they are encouraged to change the prescription on their own also, and if they can justify that they are reaching the targets, it's okay, I have no issues. But that liberty will be given only to people who can justify why or how they are going to do it. Okay? Not for, if you can't justify, just follow one rule, continue feeds overnight. Now, supposedly this patient, when you started him on feed, the doctor has written 50 kilocal, 50 ml, and every 4 hours you aspirate. So after 4 hours, if you get more than 250 ml, if you get more than, you get around 250 ml, what do you do? 250 ml, 200, cutoff kya rakhenge, 250, so we'll keep 250. So if it is less than 250, continue. If it is more than 250, only one job, inform the doctor. The moment it crosses 250, inform the doctor. If it is less than 250, continue. Okay? Later on, when you go through the whole thing, understand the whole concept, you can do, take things on your own hand. But right now, less than 250, continue. More than 250, inform. Okay? Sugar's pretty clear. One value more than 250, start insulin infusion. Or two values more than 180, start insulin infusion. Right? Yeah. Now, what should we do that? Shall we do it? Yeah, there is another concept here. This is also quite radical. Till now, we have been, when you get a gastric residual volume, what is it? I mean, you used to put a suction into the Ryle's tube and the suction used to go into the jar. Okay? And we used to discard it. But a lot of centers, they don't discard it. They aspirate. If it is less than 250, they push it back into the Ryle's tube. So are you willing to do it? Because you don't waste food there, isn't it? You don't waste medications there. If any medication that goes into the jar and it's thrown out. So this has the benefit of pushing it back. It is easy to do. But for that, along with the tape, when the patient enters ICU, along with the tape, you need to have 5 50cc syringes bedside at any point of time. So that also has to be indented and kept. For every patient, one tape and 5 50cc syringes. For that, so you aspirate it. If it is more than 5, if the 5 syringes are full, inform the doctor. Less than 5 syringes, reinsert, continue. Okay? So from now on, we'll reinsert it. No more aspirating, you know, putting it in the jar, unless and until it's a severe emergency where the patient is likely to vomit. Okay? So, you know, patient is, he's not tubed, he's likely to vomit, it's an emergency. In that scenario, you're allowed to aspirate and throw it. But if it's not an emergency, it's a routine feeding, so try and aspirate, less than 5 syringes, reinsert it, and go ahead.